Good morning, students. I hope you all are good and fine. And my name is Amarpreet Kaur. I am your computer teacher. So first thing you have to write, write date and day at the left top of your book. Okay. And then we will start a chapter first. Okay. The name of this chapter is the computer and overview. The computer means computer system. Computer is just a machine in which we see the various things. You can store the various things, okay? And the various input devices are connected to a computer, and the computer do the processing, and also various output devices we connect to the computer, okay? Now, also I will ask you for underlining a few lines, okay? Then you have to underline those lines, okay? And also highlight the important words, okay? Now, we will start reading a computer. A computer is an electronic device which accepts data given by the user, okay? Now, underline this line. A computer is an electronic device which accepts data by the user, that is input. Now, what is called input? Input is just a data which we give to the computer by just typing on a keyboard. Okay, we use the input devices to input data on the screen, or you can say on a monitor. Okay, now underline this word data. Now, what is data? Suppose we type a 3, 2, and plus on the screen, this is called a data. It also processes the data. Now again, underline this line. It then processes the data according to the given instruction and finally produces the result as output. Also underline this word, processes. Okay, then this data is processed by the computer, means your CPU. Who will done the processing? Your CPU, okay? CPU will use this data for processing. It will add the 3 plus 2 equal to 5 will be your result. And this will be your output, okay? Now, your output here is 5, okay? Also, learn the spelling of these difficult words, okay? Data. Also learn the spelling of this word input. Input is just to provide to the computer. Example I have given to you 3, 2, plus. Okay. Now next topic is data and information. Okay. Now what is data and information? I have already told you about the data and what is information. You know what is the information? Information is a meaningful data. Data should be meaningful, and that is called the information. Now let's read. Data is any collection of numbers. Okay, now you can take these examples. What is data? Data is a collection of numbers, characters, and other symbols that has been coded into a format that can be input into a computer and processed. Now, what is data? Data is a collection of numbers. Numbers means 1, 2, and 3. And what are the characters? A, B, C, D. You can say capital letters or small letters, you can say, and other symbols like ampersand sign or percentage sign. These are the special symbols that has been coded into a format that can be, and these numbers and characters are typed using a keyboard. Suppose there is a key on a keyboard A, and you will press this key and A will be typed on the screen. Okay, and then processing will be start. Okay, data on its own has no meaning. I have suppose written a 3, 2, and plus, individually it has no meaning. Okay, if first you will you are writing simply 3, 2+, it has no meaning. Okay, in other words, data can be defined, now underline this line, data can be defined as a representation of facts, concept and instructions collected for analysis. Now what is data? Data is a representation of facts and figures. Okay, the instructions which you provide to your monitor using a keyboard. Okay, first you have to type the 3, okay, then 2, then plus, then the computer will understand you are providing these digits to the computer, then it will add these two numbers, okay, then it will your CPU will add 3+2 is equal to, then we will give you the result. Okay, it is only after processing by a computer that data becomes information. Okay, only after processing. Okay, first you will give input, then processing will start. Okay, well, who will do the processing? I have already told you, CPU will do the processing. Okay, after processing, then that information will become meaningful. Okay, after adding 3 with 2, the result will be 5, and that 5 we can call a information. Okay, the main types of data that can be input into the computer. Now various types of data, you can take examples, the types of data which we can use to input into a computer. Data can be numeric, text, date. We write the date, that is also called a data. Any kind of graphics or a sound, or you are storing your photo, video, that is also called a data. Data is stored as a series of numbers inside the computer. Okay, your data stored in the computer in the form of a binary form. Okay, that language can only be understood by a computer. Only binary language can be understood by a computer. Now next topic is the characteristics of a computer. Okay, means what are the features of a computer, what are the main things included in a computer. Okay, and first is speed. Okay, computer can process millions of instructions in seconds. Okay, within seconds a computer can do a large amount of work. Okay, can perform a calculations very fastly, and same calculations that would have taken hours and day to complete can be completed in a few seconds using the computer. Suppose you are adding a very large amount of numbers, suppose like this 1, 3, 5, 8. Okay, you are multiplying this number with 1, 9, 5. Okay, if you do this calculation manually, then it will take a time. But if you do this calculation using a computer, then computer will do it fastly. Okay, the speed of computer is calculated in terms of MIPS. What is the full form of MIPS? Millions of instructions per second. Okay, please students, underline this line. The speed of computer is calculated in terms of MIPS. Okay, you have to learn the full form of MIPS. Okay, what is the full form of MIPS? Millions of instructions per second. Okay, the speed, you can calculate the speed using MIPS. Okay, you have to count the instructions here, how many data is processed within a second. Okay, next feature is accuracy. Accuracy means, you have to also underline this word. Okay, what is the meaning of accuracy? Means correctness. Okay, correctness, what to what extent a computer provide a accurate result. Okay, computer provide a high degree of accuracy. Okay, high degree. Okay, suppose same, you can take an example. If you are multiplying these two numbers, then it will give you a high degree of accuracy. Okay, give you a correct 100% correct result. It will give you, every calculation is performed with the same accuracy. Okay, accuracy will be high. Diligence. Now next is diligence. Also underline this word. Okay, now a computer can work for hours without any break. Okay, Now, what is the meaning of diligence? Computer can work for hours without any break or boredom. Okay. Computer will never get bored. Okay. It will never get bored. You can use a computer for many hours, for many days. Okay. Regularly you can use. It will never get bored. Okay. It will never get tired. You can say it will never get tired. Okay. This is the meaning of diligence. It does not get tired. Okay. Here is also written. Now, next is storage capacity. You already know what is storage capacity. Okay. Storage capacity is, you count in the form of byte, bit, MB, megabyte. Okay. Computer can store a very large amount of data. Okay. Underline this line. Computer can store a very large amount of data. You can store anything on a computer. Okay. But first you have to check the space. If there is a large amount of space available, then you can store each and everything. Okay. You can store heavy videos and you can store more than 1,000, 2,000 photos in your computer. You have many storage devices. Now, what are the various storage devices we can use for storage? CD. You already have seen what is CD, DVD, flash drive, pen drive. Okay, here you can also write a pen drive. These things we can use to store the data. Okay. Next feature is versatility. Okay. Now, what is, please underline this this word versatility. Okay. First, we will read this feature, then you will understand the meaning of this word. Okay. Computer can be used to perform different type of tasks. Okay. Versatility means you can do various things on a computer at the same time. Okay. At one point of time, you can type a document and the next moment you can listen to a song or watch a video. Okay. Suppose you have a PC. You have opened various things on your computer. You have opened MS Office, MS Word, and PowerPoint, and you have also opened a video. You have opened up various things. Okay. So you can perform a various type of tasks on a computer. So that is called the versatility. Okay. Now next is compactness. Okay. With regular advancements in technology, the computer size is decreasing. Okay. Now, as the time is passing, the computer size is decreasing time to time. In the previous time, we use computers that were in a very large size, but nowadays we everything is available in a small phone. Okay, you can also open a MS Office in your phone, but in the previous time, these features were not available, but now you can use each and everything in your phone. Okay, you can also use a tablet, okay, instead of computer. If you can't take a computer from one place to another, then you can use a tab or your phone. Okay, everything will be available in your phone as well as in. Yeah. Next is reliability. Okay, reliability. Computer does not make mistakes. Okay, you everyone know computer does not make mistakes because it is a perfect thing. Okay, if the input is correct, but one thing you have to remember, you have to provide a correct input. If you will provide a correct input to your computer, then your result will be correct. Okay, then the computer always gives a relevant answer to the input. Okay, then you will attain a right answer if you give a right input. Okay, the power of remembering. Okay, power of remembering is very high in case of computer. The data stored in the computer can be recalled at any time. Okay. The data you can store on a computer, you can use that data multiple times. Okay. Whenever you want any kind of data, suppose you have stored here your MS document. You can open that document at any time and a number of times you can open that document. Okay, you can recall at any time. Today we will do up to this topic, and you have to read up to this. This is your homework. And now, bye bye, students. Stay safe, stay home, and be happy.